Whoa! That was wild. Get out of here. Hey everybody, it's the Poltergeist 5000, back with more Dark Souls. I was trying to do a cool intro where like the first thing I do in the episode is jump attack some poor sod, and then he jump attacked me and we like went past each other cheerfully. How silly is that? So in the last episode, I killed Lautrec, and then I was like, I shouldn't have done that. Ooh, I shouldn't have done that. I'm not gonna explain what they do. And I hemmed and hawed over it for like 10 whole minutes. But then we went through but then eventually we found our way down to the lower undead burg. Made our way to a boss, and you probably can't even fucking hear me over the sound of my slosh, slosh, sloshing ass footsteps. God, that tunnel is so freaking noisy. But, anyway. Like, it's nice and atmospheric, but man, when you're trying to talk, it's like, shut up. Anyway. Yeah, so. Yeah. So this door is actually the next place we want to go, but it's locked. And our master key can't open it. Which is kind of funny that, like, you have the master key, and then, like, sometimes, like, a lot of things, it just doesn't work, and it's like, oh, well, okay, never mind then, I guess. Dude! Okay. Jeez. Spin! Sweet. Ooh, what do you drop? Bandit's knife. Hey, that's where you're supposed to, that's where you would normally get that, I guess. All right. So. Oh, jeez. Hi. Man, you guys don't know your ass from a butt. You're just, like, flying right past me trying to attack my ass? Okay, so. Oh, boy. I hope this goes smoothly. This is the Capra Demon, and this boss fight is a fuck. Like, it is an incredible fuck, because there are two dogs in this fight, and it's a mess, and I don't want to deal with it, but I have to, because what choice do I have? Now, I'm just gonna try and... You're gonna try and get an attack off. I'm gonna drinky. Because I stole my computer. And I'm gonna use a plunge attack and get... Ooh, that was not as much damage as I expected! Jeez, I can't see what I'm doing! Oh my god! Okay. We got it. We got this. That's the most dangerous part of the fight is just trying to figure out... The most dangerous part of this fight is just trying to get rid of those dogs. If you can get rid of the dogs, you're probably fine. Ah, fuck. Okay. Pay attention. Stop being stupid. Man, if I could get these fucking trees out of here, I'd actually be able to see what the fuck I was doing. Jesus Christ. It's like... Oh my god, what a pain in the ass. Thank god this guy doesn't do that much stamina damage. This guy's really not that hard once you... The problem is just that... When the fight starts out, you're in a room with a bunch of wolves, and then it's like, what the hell? It's really probably a better idea to do... Yeah, to do, like, to do dodges. Jaw dodges and jump attacks. There we go. We got him. Just play a little more aggressively, and there you go. He's not so tough. The most important thing at the beginning of that fight is getting to these stairs. Because if you can get to these stairs and get up them, you can force them to approach you more or less single file. Which lets you deal with the dogs without just getting fucking ganked from all sides. Because that is not fun. But, obviously, he gives you the key to the depths, which means now we can go down this, door. And, man, I kind of don't want to do this right now. Maybe I should stop this recording and start again later, because I really don't want to explore the depths right now. The depths are a pain in the ass, and they're not fun, and they're kind of gross, and... There are some parts that are kind of cuck-a-feeling-inducing, but it's also, like, just really annoying. I'd also like to go back to... I also kind of like to go back to Firelink anyway, because I want to use these souls, because there's the only bonfire in the next area is, like, a really long way into it, so I don't want to be exploring most of that place with, like, 8,000 souls on me. So I'm gonna be right back. I'm just gonna hop over to Firelink. Not gonna make you watch me go through this whole, like, sloshy-ass tunnel again. And we're gonna spend some levels, so be right back. Dude, why did these guys come back? I didn't rest at a bonfire. Ah! It's a good place to rest. Oh, man. Pizzoned! Okay. Yeah, if you try to run past all those... Oh my god, you're wearing the Sunlight Maggot on your head and nothing else. If you try to run past those guys to get down here, usually one of them will follow you closely enough that... If there's an enemy tailing you too closely, the bonfire will actually, like, stop working, which is really annoying. But, I'm gonna pop these souls I have, and we're gonna do a little bit of leveling. Just a little bit. I'm also probably... Okay, the Soul of the Moonlight Butterfly, I think that's the first soul we've gotten that belonged to a boss. Later in the game, you'll unlock the ability to make these souls of specific bosses into special weapons. So you might want to save them if you want to use one of those special weapons, or at least just try it out. The Soul of the Moonlight Butterfly, in particular, can be made into either... You can make it into a Moonlight Butterfly Horn, which is a spear that is basically just the horn that the Moonlight Butterfly had. Or you can make a shield that has mediocre physical damage reduction, but really high magic damage blocking. But, okay, the spear, the thing is, I should have just kept saying after going after the word but the spear scales primarily with your intelligence, which is not a stat I'm going to level up in this playthrough. And the shield, you can get a shield that blocks magic damage pretty well without having to, you know, use a boss soul. So I'm just gonna use it. And we're gonna get some souls. And that's gonna give us 1,200 souls. That's not a lot. Man, that's kind of a wafer. Now, the large soul of a nameless soldier and the soul of a proud knight. The proud knight should give us lots of souls. I think that might be 2,500. I don't know. It's gonna be buku. Okay, 2,000. We should be able to get, like, 3 levels out of this. Oh, it's gonna be tight. Ah, not quite. Dang. I would like to get my dexterity up to a little bit higher. I'm just gonna bring my strength up a bit. We're just gonna increase our damage. I want to get our dexterity up to 18 so we can use the Black Knight Sword, because we can't use it until our dexterity is 18, obviously. Ugh. Oh my god. But you know. What the heck? Someone's snoring over here? That's funny. I don't see anybody, though. When I first played this game as a kid, that scared me. It's like, what the heck? Who's snoring? I'm so scared! I think I'm gonna pee my pants! I'm so scared! Anyway. With our new sword, we should be a little more equipped to deal with these. Kind of. A little bit. Not really. These guys are still pretty strong. I was just thinking maybe I'd like to... I was thinking that it might be good to go for some of the items in here, and also to use the graveyard as an opportunity to get a few more souls to potentially... Ugh, man. Whoa! Careful, my stamina ran out. There we go. Yeah, each of these guys is worth 50. I need like 5,500 or something. Caduceus round shield. I don't really know what the claim to fame of that weapon is. But a lot of the times these weapons really aren't the random shields you'll find really aren't all that special. A lot of them might have like it's almost like more so just for role playing purposes. Any shield that doesn't have 100% physical damage block is going to have a hard time standing out as something you actually want to use. Large Soul of a Lost Undead, that might even push us over how much we need. Right here, This is a very valuable weapon. This is... Nope, never mind. Whoa. These guys can be kind of strong. You want to watch out. Don't step on me. Ow! Ow, ow, God, ow! Ugh. It's surprising that those guys are even up here, because those guys you don't encounter in, like, you don't encounter those giant skeletons again until significantly later. There we go, that's what I was looking for. The Zweihander. What the heck? Whoa! That was a lot of damage. Okay, I'm running. Oh my god! Holy shit, you're fast! Bait him. Dude, oh my god, use an attack, man! Bait him, block! Fuck! Nice. Ow. 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 Ow, god, ow. Ow, god, ow. Ow. Ow, god, ow. Everything hurts so badly all the time. There we go. Jeez, what a mess. You see what I mean about this area being pretty dangerous if you're not ready for it? I mean, we are, but... Okay, that's Zweihander. This is the weapon that people usually go for. Well, this is one of the weapons that a lot of people go for. This is an ultra great sword. I didn't realize it was an ultra great sword. Oh, man. Okay. As you can see, that weapon needs 24 strength for us to wield it effectively, so we're not going to be able to use that for a little while. Because I do want to put a couple levels into dexterity, like I said, so I can use the Black Knight Sword, because the Black Knight Sword is going to be preposterously strong once we actually, like... Okay, stop, dude. Okay, you gotta stop being this. You gotta stop being stupid now. I know they look weak because they're skeleton, but stop just being stupid. Okay, please. There we go. Ugh, what a pain. I'm halfway tempted to keep going here because this graveyard actually connects to another area right down here. I wonder if I can see any of the. No. No, the undead burg is, like, up. But look at all that. Like, look at all that, like, place that you just never explore. Parts of the world where people lived, you know? It's kind of sad. Kind of. It's pretty damn sad to think about, you know, how absolutely monumentally fucked this world is, and then to look down and just see, like, city streets and city streets. There's the binoculars. I'm going to put those... I wish there was a hotbar. Dark Souls 3 added, like, a hotbar to this pause menu, or this, like, start menu. So you could have... Because what you can do is you can actually equip, like, multiple things here to your usable items to grab them quickly. But Dark Souls 3 also added stuff beneath this, like, menu right here. It added 5 slots, and that was really convenient. But, no such luck there, I'm afraid. Now, what I'm going to do, I want to show off this area very, very briefly, but we're not going to explore this place yet because I don't, because there's not going to really be a good way for us to get back out besides just backtracking all the way out, but past the graveyard here, this is an area we probably won't explore until much later. This is the catacombs, and boy howdy, the enemies are already coming after us. For now, I'm gonna vamoose, and we're just gonna go back to what we were doing, but... The only reason I came down here to the graveyard was to get enough souls to level up again, so... And to grab the Zweihander for later. Oh, you know what we could probably do right now? Oh, that's tempting. This is something that technically you can do from the very moment you... From the very moment you activate the elevator that connects to the Undead Parish, you can do something in this area, but I kind of want to, like, put it off a little bit because it doesn't because if I go too early, I won't be able to get everything there is to get there because it'll be too hard. So I kind of don't want to go there quite yet. I don't know. I'll take 16 dexterity just for convenience sake, and we will head over to... Just for convenience sake, what are you talking about? I guess what I was thinking of there would be, like, a lot of strong, somewhat special weapons will have, like, even if they're, like, strength-centric, they'll have a little dex requirement, and 16 is a pretty common threshold for a requirement, since it's a nice, clean multiple of 8. Nose hairs, I'm gonna grind you into must. I'm gonna wrap a pipe cleaner around a Q-tip. Dude, the sun is shining right through my window, and it's going right on the screen, and I can't see, like, the top 20% of the screen. Like, what a pain in the ass. I need to fix that. That's gonna bother me. There's nobody coming after me, right? There we go, that's better. I have one of those, like, little, like, ceiling basement windows, like, right over my desk. So, especially in the winter, or in, like, the springtime, there's, like, a period of time where it, like, where the sun shines, like, right through that window, and it's, like, really annoying. I probably only have, like, a half hour max before I need to adjust it again, because it's gonna start shining on me as the sun moves that way, but... Basically, I just have a pillow and a piece of acoustic foam up there blocking the light, because for some reason my mom, like, hates blinds. I don't know. I don't get it, man. But it's easier to just pile up a pillow there than to set up blinds anyway, I guess. So, you know, whatever. What the heck? There we go. Good thing that thing swings, like, in a full 360-degree circle around me. Sure is convenient. Sure be convenient. Sure do be. Okay. Man, do I really want to do this 17 minutes into an episode? Because it's going to take us more than 10 minutes to get to the bonfire here, I think. But, eh. Dude, it's shining through again. Oh my god. Okay, I don't think I've aggroed anything. Jeez, man. Good luck shining light through a cardboard box, son. You tell that asshole. Alright. Let's see what we've got down here. What the heck? Camera, what the heck are you doing, camera? Ah, my face itches. Ah! It's like the air currents in my room are blowing around my own shed body hair. Okay. So this is the depths. This place is crawling with, like, these little wretches. And, it's kind of annoying, but... Because these guys will go crazy. In fact, some of these hollows, the ones that you see down there that are holding torches, they literally cheat the poise system. I think... Like, they do more poise damage than they should. So you, like, you literally can't no-sell their shit and just get an attack off anyway, because they will stagger you if they hit you. Which is really annoying. I mean, I guess it makes sense. If you got hit in the face with a flaming torch, you probably wouldn't be able to just shrug it off. You know? I mean, really. But yeah, that attack right there, where they rush you, flailing their torch back and forth, that can be really dangerous, because it can hit you a whole lot of times if they catch you in the brunt of it. And it comes out really quick, too. There's, like, no build-up on it at all. But anyway, that went pretty smoothly. Of course, I wasn't really expecting it not to, but now we got dogs, and the dogs are... They take 2 hits! Okay. I'm glad I noticed that before they had the chance to fuck me. Dang it. Oh, shit. Hi, Butcher. m'lady. Don't grab me with that. Okay, we got rid of the dog, thank God. This butcher will actually mind her own business as long as... And yes, it is a lady. This butcher will mind her own business as long as you don't destroy the table that she's working on. But of course the dog did, so the dog ruined things for me. Whoa! Man, that was some fucking Elden Ring shit. You, like, delayed your attack like crazy there. There we go. Fortunately, I don't think these butchers actually respawn ever. Unfortunately, that means if you don't get lucky enough to get their drops, then you're shit out of luck. Got a treasure chest here. We can open the piece of treasure chest and we can get a piece of ass. Oh, that's the large ember. That's actually really good. The large ember, you need to give that to Andre before he can actually, you need to give that to Andre for him to be able to upgrade your stuff past plus 5. And similarly, when we eventually get our stuff to plus 10, we'll need to get him a very large ember to get our stuff to plus 15. So yeah, I should heal. Praise the soup. Praise the sun! Yeah, it's too bad the verbs that you have access to in this game are kind of limited compared to the future games. And when I say kind of, I mean quite limited. Now there is another butcher down here. I want to explore this area pretty thoroughly because making another pass through here is a pain in the ass. Oh, there she is. There's the bitch now. Nice jump attack, fuckwit. Yummy! Fresh meat for my pot. Ow, ow, ow. Okay. Don't let her hit you with that attack. That's a grab. There we go. And a drop. We got the sack. I don't know if that's where you get the... Would you get off me? I don't know if that's where you get the, you can, I think you can get that machete. You might only be able to get that in the future games, but I think you could probably get it here. I can open this door? What? I thought I had to open that from the other side. Okay, but anyway, if we keep going over this way. I can't believe that door opened. I thought for sure you had to open that from your, you had to open that from the other side. Up here we have a man.
Yes, you. Over here. You must help me. You must help me.
Now, don't attack that, because you'll kill him, but, you know, just roll into it and you'll free him.
Thank you.
I would have been a sucker without you. Being in the line, I started to think. Thank you, dearly. I am Laurentius. Laurentius of the Great Swamp. And, talk to him again, I think. Okay, never mind. Yeah. A lot of NPCs in the later games you have to, like, talk to, like, 46 times to actually exhaust their dialogue before they'll move on with their lives. But it seems like they didn't... Seems like they don't do that in this game. And thank God, because that shit's really annoying. Now, down here, this is right below where we fought that first. Hey, we got a random humanity from somewhere. Nice. That's really nice. This is an area where you definitely want to have some extra item discovery, which, as you can see... Over there on the right, it says item discovery. That would normally be 100, as in 100% of the normal drop rate. But because we have one humanity, one soft humanity in our counter in the upper left, as I'm pointing to with my sword, that gives us plus 50%. And the diminishing returns on that are pretty stark. Like, you won't get an extra 50% for every soft humanity. You actually can only get up to, I think, 205? Maybe 215? It's some weird number that you can get to by using soft humanity. Past that point, the only other way to raise your item discovery is with a certain ring we'll find later. But that ring is very, very important. Oh, I fall down. Okay. Huh. Oh, this is here. That's right. I don't know my way around this place very well. Holy shit, that's a big rat. Oh my God, that's a big-ass rat. It sure enough is. Hoss. What is this? Oh, that's the spider shield. That's a shield that I think has particularly high poison resist. Whoa, 72% fire resistance? Oh, that's right. These things can't actually block any poison. Oh, wait, no, never mind. It has resistance to poison. Well, what do you know? Can I... is there anything else over on the other side that I need to pick up before I drop down here? I don't think so. Oh my god, look at all these bones. All the people that that monstrous lady has eaten, probably. Alright. That didn't do that much damage. Careful. Ow. Oh my god, this thing has a battle axe wedged in its eye. Boy, that's fucked up. Oh my god. And we get a humanity. This is a fun fact about this game, is if you ever want to grind humanity, this is the place to do it, because for some reason, and this is true in Dark Souls 2, and I think maybe even Dark Souls 3, too. Like, maybe Dark Souls 3. I know it's true in Dark Souls 2, because I remember doing it in Dark Souls 2 as well, also. Dark Souls 2, also. Rats are one of the best sources of random humanity drops for some reason. Tell me how that makes any sense, but... I guess you could make some misanthropic metaphor there, but whatever. Soul of an aimless soldier. I'm gonna two-hand my weapon here because we're in kind of narrow. I don't think I'd actually need to worry about this though. Yeah, these weapons. Yeah. Thank mercifully, these great swords don't seem to hit the walls ever. Although it might be worth two-handing just to be able to one-shot these guys. We'll explore this area a little more thoroughly later, probably, but right now, I kind of want to just... Nice. Right now, I kind of want to just... Oh, shit! I forgot that guy was here. That's another Chancellor. Bum, 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 but for some reason, I always want... Whenever I find these guys, I always want to do the, I always want to sing the way they jump, the way those guys dance when they do their like buffing ritual. Reminds me, it always makes me think of the shy guys in Yoshi's Island that dance back and forth. They're like, you know, left ahead. Oh my god. Large Titanite Shard! Pog. I'm gonna rate that a good. Ooh, that's an epic room. I wonder if we might fight a boss there in the future. Hmm. Man, this has gotta be the most... I don't feel like I'm showing this area off very well, but then again, what is there really to show off? I mean, look at this fucking place. Oh my god, what an ugly mess. Soul of a Nameless Soldier. This is here, yeah. This area is extremely familiar to me because this is one of the places where I grinded for humanity on my last playthrough. And I know exactly how to get to the bonfire from here because of that. So I'm gonna make my way over there real quick and then we'll end this episode off. But, obviously, we're not done exploring this area just yet. Still got a ways to go. Be wary of chest. Huh? I don't remember anything of the sort. Oh, man. Nice. See right here. That's a humanity for you. For some reason, the rats drop humanity. I don't know why. Ooh, a great axe. I should try that out. I think that's another one of those weapons, though, that, 32 strength, holy shit. I think that's another one of those weapons, though, that, like, you, if you miss with it, you, like, stagger. So you kind of have a hard time... Die! Okay. You kind of have a hard time, like, showing... Like, getting a feel for it before you get into actual combat. Anyway, right here, we use the sewer chamber key. Where did we find that? I don't remember. Probably some corpse somewhere. And here we go. Here's the depth bonfire. This is the only one in the entire area, I think. But, yeah. So there you go. I might actually kindle this because it's pretty... I don't really need to, I guess. Can I get 18 dexterity here? Because I'd really like to. Dude, I didn't remember to use the... Oh, you're so stupid. I meant to use the frickin' Firekeeper Soul at Firelink to upgrade my... To upgrade my good old, bad old, dang old Estus, and I forgot to. Again. Oh my god, we got a giant... Actually, that's not a giant dad. That's just someone wearing the giant dad mask. Or the giant mask. Damn, we need another 1,000. Dang. Alright, well... That's gonna do it for this episode of Heart of Dark Souls, I guess. I kind of feel like I'm ending in the middle of something here, but well, that's what happens when you start a new full-on area 17 minutes into an episode. Oh well, we'll explore this area more thoroughly, or at least try to in future parts. Until then. That was the wrong one.